Hi everyone, once again this is Harish in front of you from Vibjar Primary School Rajpalli, and we are very glad to see you on this channel. Why? Because Vibjar Primary School is also starting the online classes. So I'm going to discuss in the first class mathematics subject, and in that mathematics subject I'm going to talk about conceptual study. And after that, what are the meanings of, what do you mean by conceptual study? Then after, in that, in deeply, I'm going to do. So first of all, meaning of conceptual study. Conceptual study in the sense, reading or learning or doing something with the base of concept. Not blindly, but base of the concept. So here, after completion of this concept, or after completion of this class, you are going to understood what do you mean by conceptual study. So in this conceptual study, I'm going to discuss the meaning of basic operations in mathematics. The meaning of basic operations in mathematics. So you may get a doubt. Why you are telling that meaning of basic operations in mathematics? So here the topics you can see on the board. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. These are the four basic operations in mathematics. All students, you know very well, who are going to school, who are studying, and who are completed also, they know. But here, if I ask any addition question, then you can give the answer by yourself. Regarding to subtraction also, you can tell the answer. Multiplication, you can tell the answer. Division, you can tell the answer. Means, you have learned this process in your schooling. At the same time, you have practiced so many questions who have completed basic schooling. But now, here, I'm going to discuss with you, meaning of addition is what? Meaning of subtraction is what? Meaning of multiplication is what? Meaning of division is what? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Means, doing the problems, getting the answer by understanding the concept. That is called conceptual study. Not only doing that question blindly, but based on the concept, what is going to be happen inside of that question and why we are getting that answer, that particular answer only. That is called conceptual study. So here, these all four topics I am going to discuss with you one by one, and listen carefully. After this, if you have any doubts, you can ask us. So here, first thing I want to discuss with you, addition. Addition means we are using the symbol called plus. So listen carefully. Person, I am taking one example for each and every topic. And based on that, I am going to give the answers and I will explain that concept. So here, if student A, one student we have, his name is A, and the next student is B. Student A has 6 chocolates and student B has 3 chocolates. Student A has 6 chocolates and student B has 3 chocolates. Now, if I ask you one question, how many chocolates does B have? How many chocolates does B have? Then what is your answer? Your answer is 3. Why? Because I told that B has 3 chocolates. The next coming to, if I ask about A, how many chocolates are there with A? Then your answer is what? 6. Why? Because I told that a given information is that A has 6 chocolates, B has 3 chocolates. But if I ask, in total how many chocolates are there? Got my point? In total, how many chocolates are there? Then simply, you are going to give answer is what? 9. Whatever answer you are giving, that is correct. 9. Why you got 9? Then, here, 6 and 3. 6 and 3, total is 9, that we are expressing in mathematics called equation by using a symbol 6 plus 3 is equal to 9. In mathematics, we are converting this situation to mathematics to express in an equation, that is 6 plus 3 is equals to 9. And this you have learned in your schooling. It's okay. Up to here, it's fine. Means A has 6 chocolates, B has 3 chocolates, then total is 9. It's okay, no doubt, up to here. But if I ask, my question is to you, that is, why you are getting 9? Why not 10? Why not 8? Why not 11? Why not 12? Why 9 only? Answer is correct, perfect, nothing is there, no mistake. But my question is that, again, why you are getting 9? Why not other numbers? Then just think of about this one and pause this video and give your answer. Here, I'm going to give this answer in a clear way. Listen carefully. If I ask how many chocolates does A have, then your answer is what? 6. 6 in the sense, what you are doing here, you are doing that, you are counting the chocolates that A has. You are counting the chocolates that A has. How many those? First chocolate, second chocolate, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Chocolate first one. I am considering one line as one chocolate. Listen carefully. First one, second chocolate, third chocolate, fourth chocolate, fifth chocolate, and sixth. So your answer is what? 6 chocolates. Up here is okay? Okay. Then why you are not moving to next one? Seventh, eighth. Why? Because there are no chocolates with A. A doesn't have again remaining chocolates. He has up to 6 only. So that's why our count of numbers, counting of numbers starting from 1. First chocolate, second chocolate, third chocolate, fourth, fifth, sixth. Here if I want to keep one thing, then that must be have with A, but A doesn't have remaining. So that's why my counting of chocolates is going to stop up to 6 only. So that's why final count I'm telling is that A has 6 chocolates. Got my point? Here, counting of chocolates from 1 onwards to 6. Why? Because A has 6 chocolates. So that's why my count was started with 1 and it is going to be continuous and it is going to be end at the last chocolate. Then, coming to B. Then if I ask how many chocolates does B have, then your answer is what? First chocolate, second chocolate, third chocolate. Here also you have repeated same thing, right? What is that? You have counted first chocolate, then after you have counted second chocolate, then after you have counted third chocolate. Means here your count is going to be stopped. Why? Because B doesn't have remaining chocolates. First chocolate I kept aside, second chocolate I kept aside, third chocolate I kept aside. Again, there are no chocolates to take out. So that's why my count was stopped here. Got my point? So with A, we have started counting from 1 and we have stopped at 6. And with B, we have started count at 1 and we have stopped at 3. So that's why if I ask how many chocolates does A have, then your answer is 6. How many chocolates does B have? Answer is 3. Then if I ask total how many chocolates, then answer is 9. So why we are getting this 9 in the sense, listen carefully. Here I explained that up to 6 we have counted and we have stopped that counting here. Then again we have started counting for B separately and freshly and we have stopped that counting here. Means here one time we have counted with beginning number 1 for A and again we have started counting for B with the beginning number 1. But in total, if we are asking how many chocolates are there in the sense, here we are going to remove this what we have stopped, and we are going to replace these 1 2 3 numbers as 6 after 7 8 9. Why we are getting like this means this plus symbol is going to make a bridge between these two, means a connection between these two group of chocolates. So that's why here we have stopped individually for A for the counting, and we have stopped for B. But whenever we are asking total chocolates how many, in that case the symbol of plus is going to become in between these two, and it is going to play a very important role. That is, it is going to make a bridge between these two, and so that it is going to make our count continuous. Means after 6 again we are not stopping, again we are not starting from 1, but again we are starting from 7. So that's why after 6, 7, 8, 9 means this plus symbol is going to indicate to us that count continuously, don't stop and don't restart again, count continuously, then final number what you are getting, that is the answer. Got my point? Count continuously starting from one chocolate, then get the final answer with the last chocolate. So that's why we are getting answer is 9. So now here 6 plus 3 is equals to 9. Why we are getting 9 means we are adding that numbers continuously, adding in the sense giving this group of chocolates to this one, so that this group is going to become bigger. With an example I am going to explain, listen. If I have one jar, in this jar nothing is there, it is empty jar. So first I am going to ask this fellow, student A, to keep your chocolates inside of this jar. And simply he thrown his chocolates into this jar, so that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chocolates. Got my point? Then after I asked to B, you also keep your chocolates inside of this jar. Then he is also thrown his chocolates into this one. So that's why total chocolates count is going to become how much? These down 6 are for A and this top 3 are for B. So total how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In this total how many chocolates are there means we are going to start counting from one chocolate and we are going to end at last chocolate with the final count. So that's why we are getting total 9. Got my point? Means the concept of plus is what? Means it is going to make us to, if we have two kinds of groups or two kinds of numbers, then it is telling that start that numbers to count starting from one number, so that you should not stop anywhere and you should count that numbers continuously till the end, so that you are going to get the final answer. So here by this example I can conclude that meaning of plus is called continuous counting. Continuous counting means up to 6 we can start, up to 6 we can read, up to 6 we can count, then after again we should not start from 1 2 3. Here we are going to make it as continuous, so that 7 8 9 we are going to get the answer 9. That's why the meaning of plus inside of a problem is it is going to make that numbers to continuous counting. So that's why we are going to get the final answer.